Back to Park City.
At age three, his self-made spirit was already evident as he was able to fabricate a pair of skis with simple materials found around his home in Oberstdorf, Germany. Mind you, it was 1922, so the significant life's purpose that laid before this inventive and driven child was difficult to predict. What followed was endless adventure, along with groundbreaking inventions that continue to impact generations of outdoor enthusiasts. So after almost 100 years of his infectious smile, gregarious yodel, and simple pursuit of sharing the ride, one thing is clear. It's all about being in the moment and finding the fun. This is Klaus Obermeyer.
Arriving in Aspen in 1947, Klaus Obermeyer quickly realized the demand for practical winter wear in the elements. What started as a small business in his attic would eventually evolve over the next 70 years into a worldwide brand, encouraging the outdoor experience through groundbreaking equipment and apparel, while playing a major role in shaping the ski industry and culture we know today. Despite its immense success, Sport Obermeyer remains a small, family-run company with its vivacious leader showing no signs of slowing down.
Good afternoon and welcome. I'm Nick Sargent, the president of SIA, and I'm honored and privileged to be here today to share this afternoon with an industry icon, an innovator, and one of the founding members of SIA, Klaus Obermeyer. As we just learned in the video, in 1950, while ski instructing in Aspen, Klaus started Obermeyer in the attic of his home and used his insights gathered from instructing to build next level product. In 1953, the first American snow sports trade show, called the National Winter Sports Trade Show, was in New York at Hotel New Yorker. In June of 1955, Klaus and Sport Obermeier became a founding member of what is now known as SIA. His innovations including, but not limited to, the quilted down parka stitched together from his own down comforter, developing the first mirrored sunglasses, and I'm sure everyone had a pair, I still have a ton of them. He created the first nylon wind shirt with friend Fidel Pfeiffer, developing the first high-altitude suntan lotion, developing a dual-layered ski boot, the first with a warm liner and a rigid exterior shell, and creating the first turtlenecks with elasticized collars. If you have used any of these products in your lifetime, or your company is involved in these products today, there's only one person that you can thank, and he's sitting right over here with Klaus. To move this afternoon along, I'm going to turn this over to a good friend of mine and a good friend of our industry, former freestyle aerialist, pioneer of ski across, and the voice of ESPN X Games and action sports for the past 20 years, and most notably an Obermeier ambassador, Chris Uncle E. Ernst.
Right. 1, 2, 1, 2. Can you all hear me? Raise your right hand. Left hand? Okay, good, we passed that there. So as just mentioned by Nick, the mirrored sunglass, and I'll start with a story here. Homewood, circa 1996, I see a gentleman in a brown one-piece with these glasses on. I get on the chairlift behind him, we get up to the top, and I ask him, "Sir, what would it take for me to get those glasses off your head?" He said, "Well, what do you got?" And I had a brand new pair of Varnays and $20 in my pocket. And so I gave him the $20, I gave him the Varnays, he handed me these shades right here. I was very excited because this gentleman, Klaus, created them. I've never owned a pair, and I found them on the slopes. And I'm like, I can be like Klaus now. I got these glasses. So I cruise down. We're doing an event called Lord of the Boards. It was a creation of Ski Across. And I go down. I'm so excited. It's a nice, pretty much blue-green run. And I cross my tips, and I fall, and I crash. And if you can take a look right here, this is the original side from the bicentennial glass. This is the side that broke. It is held together by safety pins, and this is still a very important piece of equipment today for me because this gentleman created it. And that's the impact that this guy has had on me in my life through the years. So we are here today to celebrate a legend, a guy who's done so much, as Nick has said. And the number 99, what comes to mind when you think the number, what number 99? Yep, Wayne Gretzky, right? Yep, how about over here? The song 99 Red Balloons, right? By Nina, yes. And how about over here? That's right, college, 99 bottles of beer on the wall. That's it. But today, 99 fantastic years of life. He's been an innovator, a pioneer, a friend, and obviously really impacted the business that we all love so much. We have a tremendous opportunity today to hear from friends, families, business associates, and it's going to be a great time. First and foremost, I've always wanted to be just like Klaus. I've seen the ads. I've worn the clothes for 20 years. My kids have been involved with it. We've taken the stitching out. We've seen them grow. I bought a jacket when I was 12 in Tahoe City that was two sizes too big, that was a puffy. I convinced my mom that at 12 years of age, I'll wear this for the next 5 years, and I did indeed. So you've influenced my life and my family, and for everyone that has had an opportunity to work or be like Klaus right now, let's just say all together, happy birthday. 1, 2, 3.
Happy birthday!
Such a pleasure to be here indeed. And I wear this hat occasionally also. It's furry. No, it's not beaver. It's some sort of other thing, and it says be like Klaus right here. So I wear it with pride. Here, there, and everywhere. All right, let's get this thing going here, folks. We're going to bring up a whole bunch of legendary people up here, and we start with Klaus's son, president and co-chairman of Obermeier Wood Investment Council. Please welcome to the stage, Wally Obermeier.
Thank you, Chris, and thank you for all for being here. There's so many friends in the room, and I grew up with so many of you, and so you really all feel like family, so thank you. My dad, Klaus, is legendary for so many things that you know about and that we all want to emulate, but I want to share with you a side of him that you will be less familiar with. and that is that he is in his bones an environmentalist. And we grew up in a household where you literally threw nothing away. He lives very lightly. I would occasionally, as a kid, say, "Dad, if you did this in the business, you'd make more money." And he'd say, "Wally, you can only eat one steak a night." And I think that stems for his love of life and love of the planet that we live on. He never tires each day of a new run and says how beautiful it is. And but he's an environmentalist very quietly. And I remember about 40 years ago, we built the Aspen headquarters. And that entire warehouse building is completely solar heated. It was the largest tramwall for passive solar heating in the state of Colorado. The project was pictured on the front of Architectural Digest, and it has worked just immensely well. In addition, we have a solar heated pool that has been in place for that same amount of time that has just been amazing. About 30 years ago, my dad and older brother and Klaus Jr. would have been more junior, and we were sitting around the on the ranch down in Basalt and saying, "Wouldn't it be nice if we could do something good for the planet? What would it be?" And we ended up deciding that we should develop a hydroelectric project. My older brother had some experience in it, and with his great engineering, with my tenacity in getting it done, and then with my dad's blessing, we set it up as a subsidiary of Sport Obermeyer. And it's a hydroelectric project that involved retrofitting a Bureau of Reclamation dam, the largest reservoir in the state of Colorado. And it produces power for about 5,800 homes in the summer and a few hundred in the winter. And I ran some calculations just this morning. And each year, it saves about 31 million pounds of carbon going into the atmosphere. And I also project that in June 2022, we will have reached the point at which cumulatively we have saved 1 billion pounds of carbon from going into the atmosphere from not burning coal, but generating the clean electricity. And so, Dad, you are an early environmentalist. And thank you for the leadership, not only in how you run the business, but what you also do and what Sport Obermeyer does on that front. In German, we'd say, "Ich bin stolz auf dich." So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Wally. At this time, we'd like to bring up Wes and Ann Goyer, owners of Ski Bernard Sports in Dallas, Texas, one of Klaus's longtime loyal retailers. That's right. Let's give a little round of applause for the Texans coming on up.
I want to thank you for allowing me the honor of thanking Klaus Obermeyer for customer experience non plus ultra for 40 years. I want to say first that Klaus is the guy who makes you feel as a customer like you're getting a much better deal than he is. And that may have been a key to his success, but it has been wonderful knowing him for all these many years. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Public speaking is not my deal. I want to harken back to 30 or 40 years ago when the ski show was a little different and it had fashion shows. And Colmar had a great fashion show and Head had a great fashion show. But Obermeyer stuck in there longer with its kids fashion show, which is a memorable experience for all of you older customers. But the yodeling he did after that was just awesome. Klaus was kind enough to give me a ski lesson when he was 78 years old, and I don't remember being able to keep up with him. He's also a sweet enough guy to have brought us fresh eggs less than 4 months ago. He is, I'm going to let Ann talk, but I would like to say also that Obermeyer is the number one vendor for our company in 5 stores for the month of January, and that goes a long way. Bravo, Klaus.
Well, thank you. Thank you for having us do this. This is just such an honor. And what fun to ponder and share what Klaus Obermeyer has meant to us personally and professionally over the years. 45 years ago, I met Klaus and Nomi in Denver at the first show that I attended as a rookie buyer for a shop in Dallas that I was working for at the time called Ski Skeller. In the energy in that booth, I can remember the first time I ever went in there, I thought, okay, if this is what the ski business is about, I think I really like this. Because the energy was palpable, everybody was so friendly, all the products were cool. I mean, they were selling CB sunglasses, and they had, I mean, it was like a one-stop shop for your ski business. In 1978, Wes and I entered the risky business of a ski shop in Dallas, Texas. Obermeyer welcomed us with open arms as a new retailer. A lot of the vendors wouldn't. They just said, well, you have to be in business for 2 years or a year, and then we'll open you. But Obermeyer and a couple of others were the key to our success in that first year in Dallas. The company has built Klaus and the Obermeyer family has built is no accident, and the success is no accident. We've watched over 40 years in business that Klaus honestly considers us retailers his partners, and his ongoing curiosity and questioning about what our ski customers want and need has always come first. The constants that come to mind when I think of Klaus are his phrases like, there are no problems, there are only challenges. He is always moving forward, eager for the next idea of how to make the product more beautiful and functional. His ability to listen carefully is something that's always inspired me. I've heard him say more than once, we are here to listen. His smile lights up a room. His laugh is infectious. His ability to love his Obermeyer family and to love the mountains and this planet and every day of his life is amazing to me and inspires me a lot. His huge generosity of spirit and his optimism are inspirational. I think he qualifies as probably the greatest of the greatest generation of the ski industry. Thank you.
Very well said. Very well said, Wes and Ann Goyer. At this time, we'd like to bring up Greg Morrison, VP of Sales, presently for Obermeyer. Come on up, Greg. There we go.
Thank you, Chris. Hey, guys. First of all, I want to say I'm truly humbled to have the opportunity to be in this room of amazing people, family, friends, coworkers, and industry leaders. The best way I could figure to do this in 3 minutes, which isn't a lot of time, is to try to tell 3 personal stories of my relationship with you, Klaus, each under a minute, so I might blow that and go a little over. But Klaus, we first met 20 years ago. I was in my early 20s, just starting out my career as a rep in the industry. I was so stoked to be part of the ski industry, and I was doing whatever I could to make ends meet, to make a buck. Much like you, I slept in my car on the road because it was much cleaner than the hotel, which could have been an alternative that night. And I always looked at Obermeyer from the very first regional show I went to in the beautiful Poconos of Pennsylvania. I looked at the Obermeyer squad in their showroom and saw those people. And for whatever reason, I felt this emotional draw to the brand. And it's like, I want to sell that stuff someday. If you would have asked me then or said to me then, you know, Greg, in 20 years, you're going to be walking in this office every day working with this amazing team, I probably wouldn't have believed you, but I would have taken you up on it immediately. So my point of all that is you talk a lot about having an aim. Often you recognize this in others before they recognize it in themselves. You see all of us for our individuality, our strengths, ultimately allowing us to grow within, contribute, make mistakes, learn together, and simply crush it as a brand. So thank you for that. Secondly, we talk a lot about family. You know, we're a family business. So thank you to all the Obermeyers for keeping it that way. It's truly a special thing we have in the Roaring Fork Valley. When I interviewed for this position, Klaus's first question he asked me, which is not your normal first question of an interview, was, he looked me right in the eye and he said, "You have a daughter." And I was like, "I know, I got a daughter, I got a son." But the point is, he felt personally responsible for relocating, you know, two young kids to the Roaring Fork Valley from Pennsylvania, and that's just the mindset of the Obermeyers. I can tell you they're thriving, their lives are more enriched. We were like front row at the X Games this past weekend, so it's pretty good to be a kid in the Roaring Fork Valley. So the point of that story is you've really given us all, I guess, a vehicle to exist in an amazing place with an amazing family-run brand. And another note, often when Brad and I get home late from a work trip, Naomi, if we don't hit you up, we hear about it first thing in the morning the next day, much like you would from your own mother. So I could go on about exceptional stories that happen, but anyway, in the interest of time, I'll move on to the last story. And the other thing, so this past spring, had the honor of riding to work with Klaus and home for like 2 to 3 weeks. And every day I'm like, all right, I got my questions I gotta ask Klaus. You know, I've, all these things are unanswered. And I'm not sure I ever got to any of them really, but we rode to work. It was super chill, talked about family. More than anything, we talked about the animals in the fields, the blooms on the trees, whatever was blooming in the orchard that day. And I thought, you know, for a guy who's been in one place for 70 years, it's amazing that every day is like your first. And people on vacation there look miserable after 3 days. And your spirit and energy that is contagious is truly appreciated. Klaus, you're a role model. You're an inspiration to our lives, the industry. You're the man. It's an honor to work with you. That's all I got.
Nice job, Morrison. Nice job. All right, at this time, we're going to check out a little video here from the early days of Klaus Obermeyer.
Roll film.
I know you have quite a love affair for Aspen, right?
Well, we built it.
Yeah.
You know, it was a ghost town when I got right here. There was just a handful of us at the very beginning that started to build Aspen. There was Walter Pepke with money. There was Friedel Pfeiffer with the ski lift, the longest single chairlift in the world. There was a handful of people, and we all tried to make Aspen a terrific place. The first night I was here, it snowed about like this much, 6-7 inches. And then the next day the sun came out. I've never had snow to ski on like that. That fluffy, powdery, most wonderful stuff. Ideally made to convince somebody to stay,
right?
To not leave.
Tell me about maybe some of your fondest memories of those early days and your teaching lessons.
Oh, it was Yeah, it was fun to teach.
Yeah.
And you met the nicest people. Just the nice that normally you would never meet. But what skiing did is very interesting socially. The dishwasher was riding next to the guy on the lift. That was Gary Cooper. It connected the people. And so the town was one with the wealthy, with the well-educated, with the dishwashers of the time. And there was never bad skiing. There was different skiing, but not bad skiing. You
know? Let me ask you about when the snow is really, really good up here. What's some of your favorite memories of skiing these runs in Aspen?
All of them.
All of them. Yeah. You don't have a favorite favorite run?
Nope.
You just put them all together and celebrate.
Yep.
Oh, that's spectacular. Hands together for that. I sent Klaus a little gift this summer, a book of 99 pictures from my kids and some outfits that I've had through the years, and he wrote a handwritten record note back with a picture of himself, and he said, the days you don't ski, you never get back. Exactly. So get out there and ski. I thought that was absolutely fantastic. So this is just a great great opportunity today. Thank you very much. We're going to bring up the family now. So Klaus Obermeier Jr., Klaus's son, why don't you come on up here? Filmmaker, commercial director, who could speak to Klaus Obermeier's Warren Miller connection.
Awesome. Oh, what great fun to get to talk to family, really. You guys are all so close. So it's an extended family. I figured it'd be interesting to kind of break down what makes him successful and do it in like 3 minutes. What are the top things you could take away, put to your life? And you know, I'm always trying to figure it out. I had like 50 years of breakfasts with him in which I listen carefully and try and figure it out. So I think the first one is seeing obstacles as opportunities. And the quote, our greatest freedom in life is that of our own perception. It's huge, huge. And we have the choice of how we perceive things. And he's really, like, he really does it. Like, we're in traffic, 5 lanes of traffic, I'm frustrated, and he starts talking about how beautiful the stitching is on the car and what a great company Mercedes is because of the way they approach quality. Or he'll get home and say, isn't it awesome that we have hot water that's coming out of the tap? And he means it. Like, I think that's huge. So I think that's a big one. And then humor is the oil in the machine of life. That's also huge. And as I've taken the wisdoms from all those breakfasts to my job in Hollywood and doing what I do, the things that have served me the best are treating crisis as opportunity. Humor is huge in anything you do. And he even told stories of his dad. And you'd watch him at a distance from town. You'd see him walk up to a person, they'd stop, and then they'd both laugh and part. And it would go from one person to another. So I think that taking the mindset always of finding the humor in things, and it also, it takes people's fear and makes it vanish. So he approaches each interaction with trying to find the humor in it. So I think that's another secret. And exercise. And this is the one that's not glorious, and this sucks totally. Because it's basically, it's not beautiful, it's not easy, it's not fun sometimes. And, you know, he basically says, the older you get, the more you have to work out. And that is what he demonstrates every day, and that is true, and that's a big one, and that's a hard one to follow. And then there is the secret one, which I'll end on, which is, anyone who makes life look really easy and you really study it and think about what those things are, there's always something really intense working behind the scenes. And I've tried to kind of picture those things for you, which I think are the main ingredients. But I would say that Nomi, my mom, who rarely gets noticed for anything and likes to stay in the shadows. She is like, if he's the duck on the surface that looks really smooth and elegant and beautiful, she's the engine underneath that is powering that duck along. So, love you. Thanks.
That was awesome.
I didn't do any more.
That's all right. That was great. That was from the heart. That was family. That's fantastic. Okay, let's move on down the line. Everyone having a nice time so far? Yeah. What a great way to kick off SIA. All right, outdoor retailer now. We shifted on over to Marina DiMartino, former senior VP of Turner PR, Public Relations. Come on up. Big round of applause.
Hi, friends. I'm Mariana, and I had the great pleasure of working on the communications team for Klaus for about 10 years, thanks to an introduction from my dear friend Nathan Dopp here, so I thank you for that. I don't think you know this story, but about 10 years ago, I was misdiagnosed with epilepsy. And as part of that trajectory, my heart stopped one day for about a minute and a half. And when I was revived, I remember thinking to myself, if I make it through this, all I want to do is make sure I can ski again. About 6 months later, we were at a sales meeting for Obermeyer, and we had the great pleasure of doing an on-mountain day, which is, you know, an off-site meeting, of course. And my first tracks were a little sketchy. I felt a little lightheaded. 2 seconds later, I looked over, and there's Klaus whizzing by me at what seemed like 75 miles per hour, yodeling. And I thought to myself, I'm going to make it. This is it. Those are those mild markers when you really know you're going to make it. Years later, when I had my children, there are the big moments that you look forward to, the birth of your children, their first steps, their first words. For me, it was their first turns. And growing up with Obermeyer has been something that has been a great pleasure in my life. Watching my kids make their first turn in Obermeyer and still making their turns in Obermeyer is literally the happiest thing I can ever experience. And that's because of you, Nomi, and because of you, Klaus. So thank you for all of the great fun you've brought to me and my family, for always treating me and my former colleagues like family. And everything you've done for our industry. You really, really are a special person. Thank you.
That's great stuff. It just continues on. I love it. Yeah, my kids have never been in anything outside of Obermeyer. And then my son just sent a text saying, happy birthday, Klaus. So he wishes he could be here, but he's got to get to college and get a degree. All right, next up, past president of SIA, Mr. David Injimi. Come on up. Yeah.
Thanks for having me here, and it was fun to be an honor to be asked to speak, but I did bring notes because there's no way I could keep it to 3 minutes without having something written down with this. Anyway, thank you for allowing me to say a few words about our friend Klaus, who I consider more than a friend. It is with my sincere admiration and respect for Klaus Obermeyer that I provide these comments to you in honor of Klaus. Klaus Obermeyer is a very special man, and as you have heard, on how creative he was in developing products for the snow sports and outdoor industry for over 70 years. Importantly, what I would like to point out and emphasize is his respect and regards for all segments in the industry, be it supplier, retailer, sales representatives, resorts, and especially consumers. I can remember a number of times he would support issues and actions that might not be in the best interest of Obermeyer Company, but were good for the industry as a whole, be it show dates, consumer marketing, government affairs, research, or show dates. Not to repeat show dates too many times. Seriously, Klaus in many meetings emphasized the importance to hear from all sides and to understand the impact before a decision was made. He really emphasized that. Klaus is not a no man. He only wants things to be right for all or as many people or companies involved. He is persistent in his beliefs. Klaus questioned me many times on issues on issues or directions SIA was presenting, and he was thought-provoking, which clearly led us to make better decisions over the years. One of those times was when we were having breakfast in a small cafe in Aspen in the late 80s. He was loudly sharing his concerns about an issue we were discussing, when another person having breakfast who was bothered by our encounter came over to interrupt us and say hello to Klaus. This ended the conversation for the time being. After the breakfast, we went skiing where we continued our discussion and resolved our differences on the chairlift, which led to us having some fun runs down Ajax where he taught an Eastern skier how to handle the deep powder snow. Klaus has an expansive and relevant vision of the snow sports industry that goes well beyond his company, probably because he is at the top of the mountain a lot and looking out at the beautiful horizons. Another amazing talent Klaus has, as you all know, is his ability to yodel over the 99 years young. While I was at SIA, Klaus yodeled the close of the SIA show for over most of those years, and I was always emotional when he did it, and I still am. Even with all his skiing and yodeling and business talents, what sticks out most about Klaus is his big heart and smile and his laugh. He is a real friend to many of us and the industry. So let me end this with a thank you to Klaus for all he has done to help me and the industry, and to wish him many more Bluebird first track powder days. Respectfully, be like Klaus. Thank you.
Hey, bring it on. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Well, David did 40 years with SIA and his lovely wife, Nancy. They put their time in for sure, and now it's Mr. Sargent's turn. But well said right there, well read. We shifted on over now to the COO, as Chief Operating Officer for Obermeyer, Mr. Greg Bannister. Come on up, Greg. Woo-hoo. See you, sir.
Oh, Klaus. You know, I bought my first Obermeyer jacket in 1978 in Medford, Oregon at the Rogue Ski Shop, which Mr. Terry Donovan services now. And 33 years later, I was interviewing with Klaus and Nomi, and we were talking about all the different things that needed to change at Obermeyer, business systems and processes and all this stuff. And Klaus said, welcome aboard, and then went off to Maui to do some surfing. So, and that was 92 years old. And so in 3 months, I came back with a report to Klaus and the board of directors and employees and said, wow, Klaus, you know, we need to do everything. We need to put in a new ERP system. We need to do a new PLM system for the product team, a new supply chain system, a new EDI system, the warehouse is a mess. We have to put in a new warehouse management system, and we have to reconfigure and retool everything. And everybody had fear in their eyes, and Klaus had nothing but resolve and a commitment to go ahead. And his love of Obermeyer, what we do, the employees, his rep force, his retailers, these relationships, his desire to continue the company for the next 70 years was so strong, and that commitment is just so impressive for a 92-year-old, let alone now a 99-year-old. And it's when you're under stress and going out to lunch with him and he's talking about the flowers in the spring or the snow in the winter or the trees turning, he's in awe of this. And over the 7 years I've been there, I've never heard a duplicate story. Everything is full of wisdom and joy and love for what we do. So thank you, Klaus. What an inspiration you are. And Nomi.
Thank you very much. Well done, Mr. Bannister. Well, it delights me, and I'm sure you're going to find this is a nice surprise as well. We happen to have a very special treat in the house. We would like to welcome now the new governor-elect from Colorado. Please welcome Governor Jared Polis. You can do it. You got the okay. You got the strength. There you go.
Hello. How are you? Well, I'm excited to be here. Thanks for the introduction. You know, we're so excited to be hosting the Outdoor Retailer Snow Show here in beautiful Denver, Colorado. And, you know, we in Colorado really pride ourselves on our quality of life, our stewardship of our public lands. 92% of Coloradans participate in an outdoor recreation activity, and that other 8% must have just moved here from California to New York, and give them a year or two, and they probably will. You know, we lead the nation in economic contributions from the winter sports tourism, 43,000 jobs, even more secondary and tertiary jobs. It's so exciting to see the success of our winter outdoor recreation industry, as well as, of course, year-round. In Colorado alone, outdoor recreation is over 500,000 jobs in our state. We're proud to continue on the work of Governor Hickenlooper in focusing on having a Colorado Outdoor Recreation Industry Office, certainly a focal point of our economic development efforts. We're excited to build on the momentum and leadership that the previous administration hands over to us. Today, of course, we're here to recognize Klaus Obermeier, a titan of the outdoor industry, a man who really has truly embraced the Colorado way of life and has shown the way for so many others. Klaus founded the ski apparel brand that bears his name in 1947 out of Aspen, and his iconic Colorado gear can be found on ski slopes across the country. Klaus von Bayangabon, he came to this country at an early age and really lived the American dream. He's famous for saying, "Ski every day, because the days you don't ski, you can never get them back." I wish I had more time to ski, and I will try to make time with my 7-year-old and my 4-year-old this season. I think really his work embodies and success embody not only the American dream, but really truly our national and state treasure in our great state. And it's something that we need to continue to work to protect with the climate change and with the real threat to our public lands, decreasing snowpack, shorter winter seasons. We're facing an assault from Washington on our public lands. We're really facing an unprecedented threat to our Colorado way of life, the way of life that was really helped trod by the person we're honoring today, Klaus Obermeier. I was glad that just last week, Senator Bennett and Congressman Nagus unveiled the Colorado Outdoor Recreation and Economy Act, which would preserve over 400,000 acres of public land in Colorado. As a congressman, I got to work on that as well. We're proud that it includes the Camp Hale Legacy Act, which has some folks that are probably our young whippersnappers, veterans of the 10th Mountain Division, compared to Klaus. I got to meet with some of the veterans of the 10th Mountain Division a few months ago. One of them was 94 years young and was still a ski instructor. The other one was 95, and he was still fuming at his doctor, who 3 years ago had told him he couldn't ski anymore. But that really shows the fighting spirit of the 10th Mountain, and of course, preserving not only Camp Hale, but some of our most pristine and amazing areas along the Continental Divide will be a permanent tribute to Colorado, and will ensure that we continue to have the natural resources to support jobs in the outdoor recreation industry. I believe that our public land should be enjoyed over the long term rather than exploited for the short term. And I will certainly fight every day to maintain our access. I'm excited that I got to sign a gubernatorial proclamation here on behalf of Klaus. I'll just read it in part. Whereas Klaus was born in December 2nd, 1919, and grew up in a small Bavarian village in Germany. I'll try to translate that a little bit. Klaus war in 1919 geboren und in eine kleine Stadt in Bayern in Deutschland. I'm always looking for opportunities to practice my German. You know, every now and then when I was campaigning, I'd meet like a nice little old German lady. And if they were a swing voter, I knew if I broke out the German, I got their vote. You know, Klaus has a beautiful family, a staggering list of innovations, truly an American success story. He still resides in his ranch in Roaring Fork Valley, which he really got to see evolve over the past half century or more. And you know, there's so many incredible memories and milestones that Klaus has made for others, not just as the fearless founder and president of Obermeyer, but as the heart of the company, the source of jobs, the source of products that have allowed others to enjoy the beautiful outdoor recreation opportunities that our natural landscapes inspire. So therefore, I, Jared Polis, governor of the state of Colorado, do hereby proclaim January 29th, 2019, as Klaus Obermeyer Day. And I would like to present this to Klaus and wish him herzlichen Glückwunsch, Klaus Obermeyer Tag.
That's great, man. Well done. Nick, you want to come on up? Hey. Want to bring Klaus up? Let's bring Klaus up. Klaus, don't take a seat. Yeah, we're going to bring you on up here. Give you some. All right, as Klaus works his way on up here, I got a funny story. For the first time, I got to the headquarters. Walk in, take a right, take another right. And I knock on the door, and there's Klaus looking down with his magnifying glass on his paperwork, and he pops up like this.
The microphone.
There it is. Yeah, he pops up like this. He goes, "Who is it? Who is it?" I'll play the harmonica. Hey, while you yodel. Ladies and gentlemen, yeah. Klaus Obermeyer, 99. Sure, let it happen.
I think skiing is fun. You can slide on the snow. Isn't that beautiful? And before it came, before our Norwegian friends brought it to Southern Europe, the people were sitting next to the stove in the winter on the stove bench trying to stay warm. But with skiing, you got outdoors, you got up the mountains, you saw the beautiful places, you saw deer once in a while, and you were close to nature, and it's beautiful. And so it's brought more and more people to do this and appreciate our fabulous planet that has snow, that can get snow. I always say snow makes us look intelligent in the ski business, but it's a great thing that more and more people are doing the outdoors in the summer and skiing and snowboarding in the winter to bring them closer to nature and kind of feel how important it is that we keep our planet right, that we don't spoil the air, that we don't spoil the water, that we keep our nest kind of nice, you know. And I think the more people that are outdoors and see the miracle of life on this planet, will help with steps towards retaining a healthy, wonderful planet. And then I think the next 20 years will bring us more and more good answers for it. Anyhow, and in our business, what makes it work is we always create win-win situations. That way, the dealer wins, the factory wins, everybody wins. And we're nice to the problems, because the problems in our lives are our teachers. So when a problem, somebody come to my office, oh, we have a problem, say, great. Have a seat. Let's study that problem. Let's see what it really is. What can we learn from it? What have we done that was wrong before? What can we do better? And so we embrace the problems and learn from them. And there are some every once in a while, but mostly things are win-win, which is great. And I thank you for being here. And I'm happy that the outdoor show is now in Denver. Isn't that nice? So, you know, so all kinds of good things are happening. Thank you very much.
So it's a tough act to follow the governor, but on behalf of SIA, behalf of SIA past presidents, behalf of our membership and the SIA Board of Directors, we present you with his Lifetime Achievement Bell.
Whoa.
And I just, for technical sake, I'll apologize, it's a Tyrolean bell, because I couldn't find a Bavarian one.
My darling, if I wear this, will this help?
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Klaus Obermeier at 99, the legend. On your feet, please. I'll say be like, y'all say Klaus. Ready? Be like.
Klaus.
Simply put, right on. Thank you very much, everybody. Have a fantastic show. Make sure you get some photographs with Klaus if you get the opportunity. And in less than 342 days, he will be 100 years old. So God bless you. Have a great show. Thank you.